Hello and welcome to the presentation of our work titled Reflecting Surfaces for Beyond Line of Sight Coverage in Millimeter-Wave Vehicular Networks. My name is Carsten Heimann and I'm from the Communication Networks Institute of Professor Christian Wiedfeld. In Millimeter-Wave Vehicular Networks, a beyond line of sight coverage is only viable by means of reflections, as the signal penetration through obstacles is very poor. In this work, the configurable intelligent surfaces are taken into account to point out the potential of adjustable reflections for serving mobile users. The presentation is structured as follows. First, I would like to stress the aforementioned potential of reflecting surfaces to overcome the coverage challenges of millimeter wave radio links. Next, our joint mobility and network simulation framework LIMOSIM with NS3 is presented by roughly illustrating the concept based on some related works. In addition, a short validation of the overall implementation will also shed some light on the effect of the surface size. Subsequently, an exemplary case study brings this idea to a more realistic scenario. For a notional campus shuttle bus, a coverage analysis is performed utilizing the so-called RIS. As part of that, a placement strategy is discussed and the effect of an imprecise configuration in terms of the angle of reflection is evaluated. Finally, I will conclude this talk and give a short outlook on future work. Millimeter wave radio links suffer from poor obstacle penetration. Beyond the line of sight, a coverage may be viable by means of reflection path, for example via building walls and vehicles. However, the exploration of a suited reflection path may be very time-consuming and volatile, because several building walls could be taken into account and some reflection path could be obstructed themselves. The reconfigurable intelligent surface technology is a quite promising approach to improve the utilization of radio channels. At the millimeter wave spectrum, there is a need for directional transmissions. Some talk about pencil beams, meaning a narrow main lobe. In this context, a RIS may reflect some incident beam into an arbitrary direction. That is, the angle of reflection is continuously adjustable so that a moving vehicle can be tracked along the obstructed area like depicted in the figure. Since the RIS deployment would be part of the operator's network planning, the base stations would be aware of their positions. Further information about the environment, like an area map with buildings and the vehicle trajectory, might even be available to facilitate or accelerate the beam alignment and reflection configuration. For example, the base station could check for a line of sight and iterate over the available RISs to spot and serve a moving vehicle as network subscriber. So this work aims at exploring the potentials of RIS for the coverage optimization in vehicular millimeter wave networks. With this slide, I would like to introduce some related work which is assembled to our simulation framework. The basis is embodied by our lightweight ICT-centric mobility simulation LIMOSIM. Here we can import map data like roads and buildings from OpenStreetMap and configure road vehicles in terms of their mobility, like to set them on a fixed route. For the network simulation, we incorporate an NS3 millimeter wave module which provides millimeter wave network simulation with antenna, channel and propagation loss models. In this setup, RISs can be placed on the simulation playground and will be considered in non-line of sight conditions. For this, we have extended the path loss model of our previous work to switch over to another model in case of non-line of sight. This RIS reflection model is according to equation 18 of the recent work of Özdogan, Björnsson and Larsson. Due to the limited time available, please refer to their paper for further details. In this figure, a small example is illustrated to examine the implementation. The vehicle, as a network subscriber, is driving along the straight road to the right. On its way, the base station first serves it directly, since it can align the beam right to the vehicle. At the center, a building leads to an obstruction and the vehicle is now served via the RIS reflection of the opposite building. So, at the opposite building, a RIS is deployed with a line of sight to the base station, as again depicted in the right-hand side figure. In this setup, the alignment of the beam and the angle of reflection is done based on the geometry. This means the simulator is aware of the complete environment. This contains information about the base station's surrounding, the available RISs and the vehicle position. Based on the explained setting, this parameter study analyzes the effect of the RIS dimension on the path loss. The RIS is considered a square with edge lengths of 0.1 meter, about a half meter and 1 meter. The carrier frequency is set to 28 GHz, which is a common parameter of millimeter wave communications. At the transition to the non-line of sight section, the effect of the RIS size becomes visible. A small size leads to a quite high path loss. Interestingly, a fitted size can be determined to allow for a smooth transition to and from the reflected path. This may lead to the best user experience because a change of the received gain is not necessary. However, this feature requires a dynamical adjustment of the wrist size depending on the user's position and the path length difference of the line of sight and the reflection path. Since a wrist can be seen as surface with some amount of tiles or individually controllable elements, the amount of elements or their gain would need to be adjusted for this effect. As last case, quite large dimensions of course lead to a very low path loss, but the high gain is achieved by a narrow reflection beam. This directivity necessitates a precise alignment. In summary, this short study shows the larger the wrist, the lower the path loss, and in addition, a smooth transition can be produced by a fitted wrist size. However, for the subsequent simulations, the wrist size is arbitrarily set to 0.5 meter. As a next step, I would like to introduce an exemplary case study. The figure shows a map of the university's north campus with roads and buildings. The basic idea is that there might be a centrally located base station which should provide a millimeter wave-based mobile network coverage in this region. For a notional campus shuttle bus, we define the highlighted rectangular track as coverage goal of this study. However, due to the limited height of the base station and the blockages, wrists need to be deployed. For this, we applied this rather intuitive algorithm. Obviously, the non-line-of-sight sections need to be detected first. The wrists must be placed with the line-of-sight to the central base station, and they should cover the non-line-of-sight sections. In doing so, crossroads, like on the left-hand side, are preferable, if two road sections can be covered at a time. According to the wrist model, the reflection gain is high if the surface normal points to the base station. So this is initially used as orientation of the surfaces. It turns out that the coverage can be improved by rotating the wrists in some cases. Because of this, a manual adjustment is done in the last step. After this placement, the coverage goal should be fulfilled in general. Nevertheless, in our simulation, the configuration of the angle of reflection is based on the vehicle position, and this position information might be imprecise. For this reason, the provided three-dimensional vehicle position is distorted by a zero-mean normal distribution with a standard deviation sigma of 1 to 6 meters in the simulation. The results are illustrated as empirical cumulative distribution function over 20 simulation runs each. Without wrists, there is a line-of-sight coverage of only 23% of the track. Utilizing wrists, the coverage is improved now. Defining a reasonable link budget of 142 dB, with a standard deviation of 3 meters, a coverage of already 91% is reached, and as mentioned earlier, a comprehensive coverage is possible with precise knowledge of the vehicle position. With this, I would like to conclude this talk now. The main idea is to overcome blockages by means of reconfigurable intelligent surfaces, since they are believed to represent an efficient solution for utilizing reflections at the millimeter wave spectrum. The used framework is based on our LimoSim simulator coupled with NS3, and it is extended by a wrist functionality. With wrists, the angle of reflection can be adjusted dynamically and a quite low path loss is obtainable under non-line-of-sight conditions. The preliminary results of the case study prove that wrists can be deployed for enhancing the network coverage. Even with slight uncertainties, an adequate coverage could be achieved. In future work, more sophisticated beam alignment procedures based on machine learning may be studied and aerial vehicular applications like drones may be taken into account as well. I would like to thank you for your attention and I gladly look forward to your questions.